Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to this side of the multiverse, where we finished Breath of the Wild, and now we're hopping into Age of Calamity. I think I had played some of this offline, so... I don't remember everything that I completed. Oh, but I can replay chapters because this game is fantastic! I like how the organization is in this game. This is actually really nice. Alright, give me a second. Looking up where I had left off. Oh, it looks like I only did the demo stuff, and then I guess I played some stuff on the side. So we're gonna start on this level, and because we're trying to go through this stuff quickly, we're gonna do it on easy. Damage. Why would I want to take... Oh, take less damage. Increase damage, movement speed.
This looks quite satisfying. What a treat. Quite tasty.
I'll drop for Zelda. Level 4, so let's bring Zelda. Better one.
I wish to keep everyone safe, no matter
anything
what
better
we'll
for you,
see this
or
through.
Not.
Thank you.
Okay, this one is weaker, but this gives me more monster parts, which I think I need for crafting, so we'll keep that one on for now. And we're off! Adventure!
The long-lived Zora, who could traverse rivers and lakes with ease, lived in Laneru at a resplendent place dubbed Zora's Domain. Mipha, a Zora princess with the power to heal others' wounds, was selected to pilot divine beast Vtuber.
Okay. Have a good walk.
Accompanied by Link and the rest of her party, Zelda headed to Zora's domain, where she was granted an audience with King Dorophan.
King is massive.
Pilot the divine beast.
Yes. My father, King Rome, has faith she will do her utmost. With your permission, of course.
This will be a dangerous mission. Piloting the divine beast against the darkness. And I understand that the knight who will seal that darkness has not yet appeared.
That is true.
I must refuse. I cannot send my daughter into such peril.
But I...
Your Majesty! I bring news!
Well, Link, you've grown since I last saw you. And yet, you have not changed. This creature is a guardian?
Oh my god, I forgot how cute this little thing is.
How cute.
Princess Mipha! Monsters on Ploymus Mountain, marching this way.
What of my father?
His Majesty is leading the army to intercept. He thought the prince was here with you.
Sidon is missing. Find Sidon. You must watch over the domain.
Highness!
Dropping. quite understand how the combat for Zelda works. Oh, no more of that, because that was fucking confusing. You had a good walk? That's good.
Thank you.
That sounds pretty cool. Sounds pretty cool. Oh no, he's so tiny! Bring it on, this isn't Breath of the Wild. I'm not scared. Take it back, I'm scared. That's not what I wanted. Whoops. Weak point smash! Oh shit! Yes!
3-point smash!
Why would you try to fight that beast alone? I was so worried about you. But still, I am proud. What a brave little brother I have.
Yeah, that's adorable. Divine Beast Varuta. Press Y to swing Varuta's giant trunk back and forth. Okay. The first sword has appeared. Alright, get ready for frame drops. I didn't mean to use that. Hmm. Can I stop using it, please? Thank Jesus. So many Lionels, what? Catch. Hyper Beam! Don't mind me, I'm just changing the landscape with my weapon of mass destruction. We're the good guys, I promise.
Yeah. Huh?
You!
The Death Mountain.
The rugged Gorons lived in Goron City, a town carved into Death Mountain. They were forged in volcanic heat, their bodies as hard as stone. Daruk, a brave Goron whose power of protection could repel the mightiest of blows, was deemed the best candidate to pilot divine beast Vahrudanya. The princess and her entourage ventured to Goron City in hopes of securing Daruk's cooperation.
about me is that I never refuse a sincere request. So of course I'm on board with your plan. Except there is one problem. Well, it's just Varudania is in a difficult spot right now. The Divine Beast was found pretty high up on Death Mountain. A lot of monsters have been crawling around lately, so even getting close to old Rudania is a big pain. Only the bravest go up there now. So that's why it's a good thing it's gonna be us!
Of course.
Come on! Death Mountain won't climb itself. Okay.
Thank you.
still fight.
Thank you.
we got some more armor. Not that, I don't think armor does anything in the game, it's just cosmetic. I don't know. I didn't see any stats. I think it's just there for cosmetics, so for cutscenes and stuff.
It's even bigger than I remembered! Let's get right to it then! Ooh, I can't wait! That was unexpected, but we pulled through in the end. You really proved yourself, hey, little guy? Now, about me piloting Rutania. Well, go ahead and count the mighty Daruk in.
Oh, thank you, Daruk.
Of course! We'll smash that Calamity Cannon jerk to smithereens! Oh, wait a minute. You must be starving after all that fighting. I know just the cure for that. My favorite, prime rock roast. Doesn't it look delicious? Why don't you dig in, little guy? Sorry, how thoughtless of me. I should have brought some for you, tiny princess. Next time, I promise to bring enough for everyone.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The Rito resided in a settlement on the Tabantha frontier. These feathery folk were blessed with the ability to glide along the wind, and they were adept with bow and arrow. Counted among them was Rivale, the most capable warrior of all the Rito. The natural choice to pilot divine beast Var Meadow. Zelda and her companions set out for Rito Village in hopes of securing his help. To evade foes, the party tried crossing through the snowfield, but a fierce blizzard befell them, halting their progress. Link asked Zelda to wait in safety while he and the little guardian scouted the area.
This nonsense again? Rito Village is my home. While I'm here, you won't be getting any closer.
He said that to absolutely no one. What a nerd.
Coming.
I see.
Something that feels wrong fighting somebody who ends up being your friend and beating the shit out of all of his friends with a hammer.
I understand the situation now. I'm thankful no harm befell you. Either of you.
Pardon me.
Huh?
But we must address the gravity of there being another guardian resembling the little one, Your Highness.
Yes. If it is in some way connected to the Calamity, we must swiftly come up with a strategy.
Out with it. We both know you'll be needing my unique skills to pilot that divine beast. However, about this pathetic knight in your service. Are you sure he's got what it takes? What the?
Oh, I see. Our friend believes itself to be a knight as well, in service of the princess.
It... what? Ridiculous. Every last one of you.
Starved, that was great.
Mm-hmm.
The Gerudo lived in a settlement in the Gerudo Desert. Comprised entirely of women, they were a tribe of great might and nobility. For her exceptional strength and her ability to harness lightning, Urbosa, chief of the Gerudo, was the clear choice to pilot divine beast Va Naboris. Zelda knew Urbosa thanks to her close relationship with the late Queen of Hyrule. With her party in tow, Zelda traveled to Gerudo Town to speak with her old friend. However, their journey took an unexpected turn.
If we can reach her.
Okay.
Why? What are you doing?
Thwarting your destiny, of course. Princess Zelda. I came back as quickly as I could. Not exactly what I expected to find.
Abosa?
I hope you're not hurt, little bird.
I'm not.
You've got some nerve, thinking you can go toe-to-toe with Master Koga! I'll show you...
It's a top banana.
Me excluded, of course.
What?
Oh.
Come on, little guy.
Come on! Little guy!
freeze you out.
Gah!
How could these losers defeat me?
Because you're the loser, you dummy.
Ah! I nearly got peeled like a banana!
Forget these cowards. It's time to retreat.
I think not!
You're the coward that's running away! Fuck that dude! I got a broom? The fuck?
Thank you for meeting me here. The town is a bit, chaotic, shall we say.
Of course, Abosa. We'd meet you anywhere.
You know about the Yiga clan, I trust. Sheikah traitors working in the shadows to revive Calamity Ganon. Those lowlifes have been wreaking havoc here in Gerudo Canyon. How long can we stand by and watch them get away with it? No longer, I say. I will pilot this divine beast. You are precious to me, and you need my help. I cannot refuse.
Thank you, Urbosa. As Princess of Hyrule, I too will carry out my sworn duty.
Little bird. However I am able to support you, I will. Just say the word.
So, you turned and fled. Is that it?
Well, if they hadn't interrupted me...
It seems that, as low as my expectations of you were, I was overly optimistic.
What?
Well, no matter. My harbinger. Show me the future.
Oh.
Yes. The future, as it will and must be, I will not allow anyone to alter its course.
So many missions. That one just says question mark. Interesting. Alright everyone, thank you for stopping by to hang out and watch me play Breath of the Wild and then Age of Calamity. I'm actually going to stop there for now, and we'll pick back up on it later this week. If not, I'll probably be playing Mega Man Battle Network. Thank you everyone for stopping by, and I'll see you all around.